Epic is one of the most successful applications running on pure FlashArray, and more than half of the installations run on IBM Power and AIX, and therefore are not supported as a virtual machine on Amazon Web Services. The idea behind this demonstration is to show how the recovery process works on a system which is not supported on AWS, but that we can still benefit of the S3 services of AWS to back up and restore the data across the country and use it in case of a catastrophic failure or more simply migration of a data center. The configuration in the primary data center include an IBM Power with AIX connected to a FlashArray and running an Epic I/O generator which simulate the real database behavior. The goal of the demonstration is the recovery process. But before we can do that, all the data have to be sent to the AWS S3. To do that, we have to connect the primary arrays to AWS S3 and take a daily snapshot, as well as replicate it to the S3 AWS. This process was demonstrated in the previous presentation. If a catastrophic failure occurs on the primary side, then we can connect to any site with a FlashArray and an IBM Power with AIX and start the recovery process. Once all the connectivity are okay on the new data center, we just need to connect the new FlashArray to AWS. And after collecting the information on the AWS website, in this case, we know that the bucket that we're going to use is called Snap to AWS, and we need also the secret and the access key. We just need to select connect to S3, and we can start to fill the form, adding the access key, the bucket name, and the secret name. We don't need to initialize because the data are already saved on the S3 system. You can see that the access key, the bucket, snap to AWS, and the secret key. After clicking on the connect, the system is connecting to the AWS S3, and as you can see, it's scanning. When the status becomes connected, we can select the target, and then within the target, select the get icon to select the different files which have been saved. You can see everything is automatically downloaded on the system. Then, by going to the volume selection, we can select each volume independently, each snapshot independently, and restore it to the system. And as you can see, it creates a new volume for each of the snapshot. Once all the volume have been created, we just need to go to the host configuration associated with the that are going to be our target, and once it's done, we can go to this AIX system and start to import the different volumes. To do so, we check that there is no connection right now, run the cfgmgr-v, which we scan the system for new devices. So once we run the LSPV, we can see that there is 4 new volumes, and after validating this volume, we can run the command import vg to import the entire volume group that we call prdvg on the system. Take a few seconds. Then we can validate that the logical volumes have been created and are ready to be mounted.
using the LSPG, and then we can do the mount command on the Epic PR-01 and Epic Reach. After this, all the volume have been mounted on the system, we can start to run the Epic IO generator called Generate IO and validate that everything is up and running. That's all I have for today. This demonstration shows that even with an operating system not supported by AWS, we can still use CloudSnap for backup and recovery.